it's Harry and Meghan, a real romance, and she's not playing Harry. You know her from Jessica Jones and Luke Cage and Midnight Texas. This is really interesting. Parisa Fitz Henley.
Yes.
So I think when people say that name, I anticipate somebody with dripping with a British accent.
Ah! Well, my first name is actually an Iranian name. Mm-hmm. And then the last name, we understand, I think it's from the Scottish end of my family. Jamaica is where I'm from.
I see.
Lot big British, Scottish, Irish influences there. So,
And then you were saying this is such an interesting story that you, no one had told you, oh, gee, resemble her.
Never.
But you watched the interview that she and Harry did when they got engaged.
Yes.
And what struck you?
I just thought this is such an interesting woman. She's so grounded. I was very intrigued with the way that she carried herself. And then I thought, well, I see a certain physical resemblance. I feel like I'd love to try walking in her shoes for a day. Asked my manager to just keep an eye out, and if there was ever an audition, I'd love to audition for a movie about her if they did one.
All right, this is the side-by-side we put together. When you look
I mean,
at that,
look at
yeah,
that.
Now you identify
when I,
yourself?
When I see the hair straight,
right.
yeah, then definitely since when they do my makeup and my hair like her, mm-hmm. I definitely have mixed up pictures of us.
Wow.
Just, right.
Yeah, at a glance, I've been like, oh. That's me. Or that's
so her. So when you mm-hmm. would go to shoot the movie, mm-hmm. and you'd go into the makeup trailer, and then they were done, did you ever think, oh my God, like, I'm her?
I mean, less when I'm just live looking at myself.
Sure.
I mean, I always just felt really lovely because they did really beautiful work. It's very subtle work, but it takes a long time to do the kind of detailed work that they did. So I just always felt really nice. And it's like, oh, Meghan just feels like this all the time.
Sure.
She just rolls out of bed like this.
In the back of your mind, just a little thing saying, if only I had that chance encounter in Toronto instead of her.
You know, I love playing her and stepping into her shoes temporarily, but that's quite a life that she's
right?
living right now, and I like mine.
Okay, fair enough. Here is a clip. We will watch our guest at work. Look at this.
Hi there.
Hi. I'm Meghan.
Hello. Yeah, I'm Harry. You look.
Thank you. I'm gonna actually need you to hold off on the compliments until you have apologized for being 40 minutes late.
Was I? Sorry, I didn't realize.
Really? Can I just show you how this works? You see here this shorthand? That one is the hours, and the long one is the minutes.
Hmm. I've always wondered about that.
Have you?
In English boarding school education, it's highly overrated.
We're Hollywood.
All right. Yeah. I like that clip very much. Please re-ask your question.
I said, is that really what happened?
Well, we don't know. You know, the creators really did their best to get as much of the public details in as possible, and you'll see, like, all the big moments are covered in the film. But the private stuff, everyone had to trust their I guess, artistic intuition.
Yeah.
To go with it and see what.
But do you have enough of to put in? Because the idea we're getting is she's pretty sassy.
Yeah.
So
I mean,
they.
She is.
Yeah, she is. Okay.
Yeah.
And then in the course of your professional work, because you know this happens sometimes, you've gone into an audition room and there's 20 people and it's like, oh, I didn't know there were 20 people like me.
Oh, yeah.
Have your paths ever crossed?
They must have. I mean, I would guess that they have. We've never met. I mean, definitely the last thing you want to do is pay close attention
right.
to the other people in the
sure.
room when you're auditioning. So, yeah, I don't know.
And then the other thing I was thinking of, and we were sort of talking about this, she worked on Suits for 7 seasons.
Yes.
For a working actress, she had a relatively, if not very, low profile.
Yeah, I wasn't super aware of her. I know I'd seen her in a couple of episodes of Fringe, which I'm a big fan of. So I was like, oh yeah, she's. I remember when she popped into that show. But it does seem like she's lived a pretty discreet life so far. Well, up
until now.
All right, we will tell folks, Harry and Meghan, A Royal Romance, is May 13th at 8 on Lifetime. Really nice to meet you
Lovely
this morning.
Lovely meeting
you.
Thanks for having
you.
Thanks.
Wow.